So this is the seventh lecture of our subject digital system design, and the topic which we are going to cover today is circuit realization. So these are the contents of today's lecture: circuit realization using basic gates, NAND gate and NOR gates. In our previous lecture we have already seen that how to minimize the Boolean expressions. We have first covered that minimization using Boolean laws, then we have covered the Boolean expression minimization using Carnot maps, and then third method we have already seen as the tabulation method. So all these three methods provide me a minimized expression. Now that minimized expression has to be converted into a circuit for the practical implementation. Okay. So there are three ways by which this can be done in form of gates. In from the scope of unit one, we can say that these are the three methods. As we proceed to unit two, then we will see that there are other methods as well to realize these circuits, or any circuit, any expression can be realized with the help of some specialized circuits like multiplexer, demultiplexers, but that thing will be seen in our unit 2. So from the scope of unit 1, these are the three methods, that is the circuit realization using basic gates, circuit realization using NAND gates and the NOR gates. So let us start with the circuit realization using basic gates. So basic gates are the three gates: AND gate, OR gate and NOT, AND OR NOT. So these are the three basic gates. So any expression which is provided to me, something like this, this is an expression provided to me, and if I am asked to realize a circuit for this, then I have to first identify which all gates are required. Then I can see that A is having a bar, B is having a bar, that means definitely I need a NOT gate. Then I can see that these two variables are being multiplied, that means I need two AND gates. And then I can see that this product and this product, once these two products are ready, they are to be added together, that means I need an OR gate. So this gives me the requirement that two NOT gates are required, two AND gates are required and one OR gate is required. So let us convert this into a circuit. A is there, which will be complemented to generate A bar, then B is there, this prepares my first product. Okay. Similarly, the second product is B bar C. So this B can be taken from here only, this generates B bar and this has to be multiplied with C. So both the products are ready and they have to be just added together with the help of OR gate. So this is a simple realization of this expression. So this is, we can say, AND OR structure. This is AND, that means the first there are products and in the later stage there is a single OR gate. So I can say that this is an AND OR structure, and this thing is already mentioned in SOP form. So I can state there that SOP will be providing me AND OR based structures. Okay. Similarly, I can see that now this second expression which has to be realized is a POS expression. So from this POS expression I can see that this B bar is required and there is no other variable which needs to be complemented. So there is a single NOT gate requirement, then I will be using an OR gate here, an OR gate for this second sum, and then both these sums will be multiplied with the help of an AND gate. So let us prepare it. So this is A and B, both are to be summed using an OR gate. This is A, this is B. So this generates the first sum, and similarly this is B, we have to prepare B bar, and then there is a C, again both are to be summed and both the sums are to be multiplied together to generate the final output Y. So now from this structure we can see that there are OR gates in the initial stage and an AND gate in the final stage. So we can say that these POS expressions, so these POS expressions are related with OR AND based structures. Okay. So we have came to know that SOP expressions can be easily realized in AND OR form and POS expressions can be easily realized in OR AND form. Okay. So now let us proceed. Now this expression is to be realized again using basic gates, but this is a bit complex expression. So we cannot proceed in a random manner, whichever variables component or variables inversion is required, product is required. We will not be using these components on need by need basis. We have to think carefully so that a systematic structure, a systematic circuit is prepared. So we have to first see that how many variables are there. So there are three variables, A, B, and C. So I have to draw three vertical lines A, B, and C. Okay. Then I can see from the expression that A bar is required from here, C bar is required, B bar is required. That means all variables inverted versions are also required. So I am preparing A bar. Similarly, B bar, C bar. Now, A, B, C, A bar, B bar, C bar, all these things are available to me. Now, I have to just prepare the first product A bar, B, C. So, this is A bar, this is B, and this is C. So, these three terms can be multiplied with the help of AND gate. Similarly, the next product is the product of A, B, and C bar. So, this is A, this is B, and C bar will be taken from here. So, this generates my second product. Similarly, the third product is A bar, B bar, and C bar. So, this is A bar, B bar, and C bar. Again, they have to be multiplied with the help of AND gate. Similarly, the last product is AC, A, and this is C. Again, an AND gate. So, all four products are ready. Now, all these four products are to be added together with the help of an OR gate. So, this is the systematic preparation of this complex looking expression. First of all, we have to prepare the negated version of the variables, then generating the products, and then in the end generating the sum. So, this is a systematic version of this circuit realization. Now, coming to the NAND based realization of any expression. So, I am again to proceed with the NAND based realization, I have to obtain some kind of a rule so that I am easily obtained to, I can easily obtain the NAND based realizations of the circuits. Because if I am using the universal equivalent, universal realization based equivalents of AND or NOT versions, there will be quite a number of AND gates which will be required. So, we have to generate some equivalences. Like I have mentioned here, I have to prove that equivalence AND OR realization is similar to NAND. That means, AND can also be replaced with the NAND, OR can also be replaced with the NAND. So, we have to prove this that it can be done. So, let us take an example that Y is equal to AB plus CD. This is a very, very simple example which has been taken to prove this equivalence. So, we can see that this AB is a product. Again, then this CD is also a product. And both these products are to be summed. So, this is the basic realization of this one. So, now if I replace all these AND and OR gates with the help of NAND gates like this one, so I am saying that both these structures are equivalent. That means they are working, they will be working exactly similar. I can see that this will be giving me A B whole complement, this will be giving me C D whole complement. Similarly, this Y will be giving me, this is my first input of this, if I label them 1, 2, and 3. So, to this third NAND, there are two inputs A B bar, second input is CD bar, and both these will be multiplied and further there will be a complement. So, if I apply De Morgan's theorem on this, then I can check that I will be getting AB double complement, this dot will change to plus, and CD double complement, which will be equivalent to AB plus CD only. That means I can say that this AND OR base structure is exactly similar to NAND NAND structure. That means I am authorized to use AND and OR gates. I am authorized to replace AND and OR gates with the NAND gates. That means NAND base structures can be easily prepared for AND OR structures, and AND OR structures are directly related to SOP. Okay. So, SOP, AND OR and NAND NAND, all these three things are interrelated with each other. SOP, AND OR and NAND NAND. So, using this concept, we can realize any SOP expression with the help of NAND gate only. So, let us suppose now this expression has to be realized using NAND gates, then it is very simple. I have to generate A, B and C, okay. Three vertical lines for these A, B and C, then C, A, B and C, all those variables complemented version is also required. So, I am using NOT gate in the form of NAND only. So, this is the NAND equivalent of a NOT gate. Similarly, here as well, so in this way we have prepared the initial layout, initial variable requirements are being satisfied, then the first product A, B, C bar, this is my A, this is my B and this is C bar, all these have to be multiplied, but instead of using a AND gate for product, I am using a NAND gate. Then again A bar, B bar, C bar, this is my A bar, this is B bar and this is C bar, again I am using a NAND gate. And the third product is A C, so this is my A and this is C. So, all three products are ready and now they have to be added, but instead of using an OR gate for addition, I am again using a NAND gate because I have proven it already that AND OR structures are similar to NAND NAND structure. That means, in place of AND and OR, we can replace them by NAND. So, this is the NAND realization of this expression. So, it is very much clear to me that SOP expression can be easily realized using NAND NAND structures. Okay. But one thing which has to be kept in mind, if I have to realize this A B plus C kind of structure using this NAND gate, then I have to keep in mind that AND OR structures are similar to NAND NAND. That means, this A B can be in form of this NAND gate, but this C has also to pass through a NAND gate, only then it will be considered as a AND OR based structure. This there cannot be direct connection. That means, this is my circuit for this A B plus C. That means, this C which looks like a plain variable, but this also has to pass through a NAND gate, only then it is equivalent. We can prove it, like here A B complement, I will be getting C complement here, and here I can see that A B complement dot C complement and further complement, and if I apply De Morgan's theorem, I will be getting A B plus C. Okay. So, we have to keep that thing in mind as well. So, this is the NAND realization of SOP type circuits. Similarly, if a POS expression is provided to me and I am asked to generate the NAND expression, NAND equivalent of this POS type expression, then we have to convert this POS looking expression into SOP type expression by complementing it. If I complement this expression, then I will be getting Y bar. So, that means, I am complementing this, that means, I will be getting A plus B plus C complement whole complement, this dot will change to plus, then again A complement plus B complement plus C complement whole complement, again this dot will change to plus, and there will be A complement plus C complement whole complement. Okay. Now, further applying De Morgan's theorem, I will be getting A bar B B bar C. Similarly here A B C, and the third term will be A. We have to complement this one. So, by mistake I have placed bars here. So, these bars are not required because they are plain numbers A and C. So, it will be giving me A bar dot C bar. So, this is now SOP looking expression, but this is in the form of Y bar. So, I have to realize this. I can also assume that these inverted input variables are also available to me. That means, I can simply use like this A bar, B bar and C. Another product is A, B, C. Third product is A bar, C bar. So, all these are NAND gates. They have to be added together. For addition, I am again using a NAND gate. But the thing is, this is the expression for Y bar. This is not Y. We have realized the expression for Y bar. And now, to obtain the expression for Y, I have to place an additional NOT gate here in the form of NAND only to negate this complement. So, this generates Y double complement, which will be exactly equivalent to your Y. So, in this way, we can realize POS based expressions with the help of NAND gates. Okay. Similarly, continuing in this fashion for circuit realization using NOR gates. Now, we have to first again establish the equivalence, which will be helping me in realization of NOR gates, NOR gate based structures. So, that equivalence which needs to be established is OR AND a realization is equivalent to NOR NOR. That means, OR AND based structure. So, this is OR AND type expression. OR AND we can say, or we can say OR AND can also be termed as POS type expressions. Okay. So, this A plus B into C plus D, that means, this A plus B is your sum A B again C and D, and both have to be multiplied. So, I am using a AND gate. So, this is a basic gate level structure of this expression, this POS expression. So, this is your A plus B and this is your C plus D, and this generates A plus B dot C plus D. Now, if I have to prepare the NOR based structure of this one, then I can simply replace OR gates and AND gates both by NOR. That means, something like this. So, this is A, B, C and D, and this is my Y. I have to prove that these two structures are exactly similar. So, for this I am writing the intermediate expressions like A plus B whole complement. Here I will be getting C plus D complement. So, and here this Y will be A plus B whole complement plus C plus D whole complement and further complement. So, if I apply De Morgan's theorem on it, then I can check that this translates to A plus B into C plus D, because these double complements will be cancelled out. So, I can see that both these structures are exactly similar. That means, I can use NOR gates in place of OR gate and AND gates both. Condition apply, the structure, the expression has to be in POS form. Okay. So, I can use that, I can make a statement here that OR AND structures can be realized using NOR-NOR structures. Okay. So, now let us start with, now let us take an example. Let us suppose this is an expression which is being provided to me, which says that y is equal to a plus b plus c complement dot a complement plus b complement plus c complement dot a plus c. That means this is a POS type expressions. Okay, this is a POS type expression, and there are three variables a, b, and c there. So these three variables, now I need to prepare. This is a, this is b, and this is c. And NOT version or the complemented version of all three are required. So I am using the NOR based NOT structure. Okay. Similarly, here as well, NOR based NOT structure. Similarly, here okay. Now, this sum has to be prepared a plus b plus c complement. So, this is a, this is b, and this is c complement. Instead of using an OR gate, I am using a NOR gate. Similarly, for the second sum, a plus b, a complement plus b complement plus c complement. So, this is a complement, sorry, this is my a complement, this is b complement, and this is c complement. And the third sum is a plus c. So, this is my a and this is my c. So, all these sums are ready, and to prepare the products I need an AND gate, but in the previous slide we have already established the equivalence of OR AND structures. That means, in place of OR and AND I can use NOR. That means, I will again use a NOR gate here as well, because I have already proven that OR AND structures are equivalent to NOR NOR structures. Okay. So, this is the NOR realization of this expression. Similarly, like in NAND gate we have seen that there has to be an OR gate, and that OR output has to pass through an AND gate. Both these are required to generate NOR based structures. That means, if I am provided with something like this a plus b into c, and if I am asked to generate the NOR structure for this, then I have to use, it is very much clear that for this sum I will be using a NOR gate, but this c will again pass through a NOR based NOT gate. So, this is a, this is b, and this is c. It can be proven that this is equivalent to this one. So, a plus b complement, and this is your c complement, and here at this point we can check that a plus b complement plus c complement and whole complement. So, if I apply De Morgan's theorem on it, I will be getting a plus b double complement, which will be cancelled out, and c double complement, which will again cancel out. So, I can see that equivalence is established, the expression is, the circuit is giving me the correct expression which it intended to provide. Okay. So, this is the POS realization using NOR gates. So, similarly, now if I asked to prepare the NOR based realization of an SOP expression. Okay. So, for this I should be very much clear that these SOP based structures can be realized with the help of NAND gate very easily, but for NOR gates the structure has to be in the form of OR AND or POS like structure. So, for this I am complementing this, that means I am generating Y complement. So, I am generating Y complement. So, for this the structure will be something like this A B C complement whole complement, this plus will change to dot A complement B complement C complement whole complement A C whole complement. So this is y bar, and further writing it, further applying De Morgan's theorem, I can see that I will be getting A bar plus B bar plus C. Similarly, this will be converted to A plus B plus C. Similarly, this one A bar plus C bar. This is Y bar. So, now I can see that this Y bar expression is identical to your POS type expression, and these POS type expressions can be very easily realized using NOR gates by simply replacing AND gate by NOR gate, OR gate by NOR gate. Okay. So, all these gates are to be replaced by NOR gates, and these NOT are also to be used in form of NOR only. So, we can realize here. So, if A is there, B is there, C is there. A bar B bar C bar. So, the first thing is A bar plus B bar plus C. So, A bar plus B bar plus C passing through a NOR gate. Similarly, the second thing is A plus B plus C. A plus B plus C passing through another NOR gate, and the third one is A bar plus C bar. So, this is A bar and this is C bar, and all these will further pass through another NOR gate, but this generates Y bar. But I need to prepare the circuit for Y. That means, an extra NOR gate will be required, and it will be placed at the output of this expression to generate the complement of this gate. So, I am using another NOT gate, NOR based NOT gate. So, this will provide me the expression for Y. So, in this way we can see that AND OR based structures can be realized using NAND AND structures, and OR AND structures can be realized using your NOR based structures. Okay. So, all these components can be replaced by simply either NAND gate or NOR gates. We have to just remember this single concept: AND OR, SOP and NAND AND identical, OR AND, POS, NOR NOR are identical. Okay. So, this is how we can prepare the circuits using basic gates, NAND gates and NOR gates. So, with this we come to the end of this lecture. Thank you very much.